Hi, welcome to this success story that we're starting today.
Right now, I have managed to crack an internship at Google.
Can you tell me a little bit about the preparation that you started?
I came across programming Pathshala at this point. It has been a consistent journey of learning DSA, learning problem solving.
What was the difficulties that you were facing?
So when the sir says pause and think, so you have to pause and then you have to take up a pen and paper and do something.
I think that will be a really great advice for everyone.
And these questions were really tough. So this time, a more experienced engineer from Google was in front of me.
Hi, welcome to this success story that we're starting today. Let's straight away begin from a little introduction from you.
Okay, so I am Rhythm Patni. I am currently a pre-final year student at IIT Jodhpur, majoring in computer science and engineering. So first of all, like how I got at IIT Jodhpur. So I am from a so-called COVID batch. So my 11th and 12th, both of them were online. So I had 2 years of JE preparation online from home. And I managed to get a good enough rank to get IIT Jodhpur CSE. And from then on, from first year of college, I started learning programming. And right now, I have managed to crack an internship at Google.
That's great. Congratulations. So can you tell me a little bit about the preparation that you started? Which year did you start your preparation for your placements and everything?
Okay. So I was fortunate to know about internships and placements and what to do about it, what not to do about it from after I completed my first year. So in the summer between first and second year, I got exposed to DSA, internships, placements and all of that. I came across programming Pathshala at this point. So I started my preparation from that summer. And then from that, it has been a consistent journey of learning DSA, learning problem solving from programming Pathshala and then cracking Google.
Okay, got it. So you started in your second year, like in your semester break after your first year ended, is it?
Yes.
Okay, understood. And you joined the course Renaissance to start your preparation.
Yes.
Yeah, can you tell me a little bit how that journey was? How helpful was it? Or what was the difficulties that you were facing? Everything.
Okay, so when I joined the course, the initial learning curve is very high for problem solving in programming, right? So I just knew very little C++, that also I learned in college. So okay. I was not comfortable in C++ or any other programming language at that time. So the great thing about programming Pathshala is that everything is basically taught from scratch. And every time it is taught, like the concepts are mostly repetitive. So every time it is also taught, it is taught from scratch and the entire code is being explained to you from scratch every single time. So that's what, so when you listen to one thing over again, and over and over again, that's what builds the intuition in your mind for you to use it later in time.
Got it, understood. And were you able to finish the entire course?
No, I did not finish the entire course. I finished all the modules, the videos, but I still have some homework to do.
Okay, nice.
Homework questions.
Okay, great. And how did that help you with your problem solving skills and everything, is it?
Yes, again, I would like to say that in every module, the videos first start with the explanation of the problem to make sure that we understand the problem. And in the video, the Vivek sir or Bharat sir, they ask you to pause and think. So I actually did pause and think at that time and kind of digest the concept that is being taught. So That was very helpful.
I think pausing, thinking, and then practicing those concepts really helps with the learning that you're doing.
So when the sir says pause and think, so you have to pause and then you have to take up a pen and paper and do something. You have to write and
check. That's a really good advice.
You really can go forward in the video.
Yeah, I think that would be a really great advice for everyone. And if I ask you, then how did you come to Google? Where did you apply? Did the company come to you from college or you outsourced it yourself?
So when the Google released its internship, I first applied for it off campus.
Okay.
So after a few weeks, the Google visited my campus at IIT Jodhpur. So first, I still remember the date, on 13th of July, we had our online assessment, and these questions were really tough, like above lead code hard level, like code forces 1600 to 1800 rated problems. If someone solves code forces, they will be able to relate. So these problems like were very tough. So I managed to pass a few test cases, and from what I know, as far as I know, I got shortlisted on the basis of my resume and the CGPA, which I had maintained. Okay. So I had like close to 9 CGPA maintained throughout my 2 years, four semesters. So I personally think that I got shortlisted based on the CGPA because the online assessment was really tough.
Okay.
So after that, like I received an interview call. So the thing was like I received the call, and the next day morning 9 p.m. I have the interviews. So I just had my 8 months of preparation that I had done. That only had my back. Like I didn't know. I didn't have any time to even think. Okay, I have an interview. What to do? I didn't even get a chance to think about anything. Just straight off next morning, I have my interview, and by God's grace, I managed to clear it.
Yeah, yeah.
Two rounds of it.
And a lot of hard work for a long time.
Yes.
So I think the two highlights you mentioned were one thing was that you maintained your CGPA throughout, which I think is a little important if you want to aim a good campus and a good placement. And the other thing is like consistently that you mentioned earlier was you need to do your preparation consistently. And I think that the impromptu interview just like pushed you to like showcase actual skills that you have, because you didn't prepare anything, you didn't mug up anything. That was everything that you learned for a long period of time that you had to present there.
Yes. So the entire process was over and it happened so suddenly. I didn't have any chance to prepare. So only thing that had my back was my preparation, which I had done honestly and consistently in 8 months.
Yeah, yeah, it's really nice. So I want to understand like what would you call the interview process as? Was it easy? Was it mediocre? Was it really hard?
Okay, so like going into the interview, so the one thing I had managed to do before the interview was I took a mirror in front of me and tried to speak English. So like I was confident enough that I would be able to at least approach the DSA problem that would be asked. But anything that can go wrong is the communication. So I just practiced communication in that 3 to 4 hours that I got. And then I sat for the interviews and I was feeling comfortable in the interviews. Like the interviewer first comforted me. So he was like, have some water and get yourself comfortable before we can start the interview. And once the interview started, the problem was presented to me. So the interviewer pasted the problem in the doc and he asked me to read it. I read the problem and explained it to him. And due to the preparation level of mine, within 10 seconds, I knew how to solve the problem in the most optimal time. So I first gave him the brute force and then optimized it step by step, and then had the code written also. And that was the first round. It was a medium problem. It was like range queries on matrices. So I gave the brute force first and then I optimized it with some pre-computation. And then that was the first round. So the thing was like after this round, it lasted like 45 minutes. And there were 3 follow-ups on this question itself. And then after 45 minutes, like I had to wait for 15 minutes more to get a confirmation for second round. So it was in these 15 minutes, 9:45 to 10, I was supposed to get a confirmation of whether I had cleared the interview or not.
Yeah.
So the confirmation came and I had to sit for a second round. So this time a more experienced engineer from Google was in front of me. So he asked a harder question. It was like, it is also a standard problem, job scheduler using priority queue, like the hard version of that. And I managed to do it that also with 3 follow-ups. He asked me, I had to code the question in like these, the interviewer shared like a doc in front of me. So it is not any kind of Google Doc or any, it was not an editor. There was no autocomplete. So you had to have a grip of how the implementation and the coding actually works, because there is no autocomplete and there is no auto assistance in that IDE which is shared with you. It is so in any IDE which we regularly use, if we write opening bracket, the closing bracket automatically comes, but just because it is supposed to come. But in that doc which was shared to us, like there was, it was like a notepad basically. So you had to type every single bit of code without making an error, without missing a semicolon, and without like making a mistake in variable names, etc. So the many mistakes can happen. So we had to avoid every bit of that, and we had to present the code and even make it readable and explain it to the interviewer at the same time. So that's where the implementation skills that I had built up that really contributed.
Got it. So if I now ask you, after that you've gotten all of this, what was the highlight moment for you?
So the highlight moment was that I, when in the both the rounds, when I saw the question, within 10 seconds I knew how to solve it. So
that's a different level of confidence, right?
Yes, that's due to like 8 months of hard work and dedication. And the main thing which I feel that anything which could go wrong in my interview, which I knew, was the communication. And I somehow managed to communicate really fluently, and the interviewer also connected with me every single time. And the communication was the key highlight for me.
Okay, that's nice. So how were your parents feeling when you told them the news? What was their reaction?
So it was like very late at night on the same day. So like at 11 p.m. my interviews were over, and then I immediately rushed to the classes which I had been missing. So I missed a couple of morning classes for this. So immediately I rushed to the classes, and then after that regular day, meeting everyone, meeting the friends itself, it was a regular college day. And then at night, 12 p.m., the message comes, like the shortlist comes, and I'm like, oh my god, I have been shortlisted. And I immediately called my mother and father. So they were together. They told me that they were almost about to be asleep, but they knew because they were not, because they knew that the shortlist would arrive. So they kept, you know, themselves awake, and then I gave them the call, and then they were like very happy. So I was not with them. I was in college at my hostel, but still, I wish I would have been with them at that point in time. But I had to be in college.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
The very next day, they both rushed towards the temple, and and thank God.
Yeah, that's really nice. Okay, thank you so much. Before we end our small interview, I want to understand, like, what made you keep motivated? So you told that you said a couple of times that you were working really hard for 8 to 10 months, but what was the key to your consistency?
Okay, so the one thing that kept me motivated was like how my parents have worked hard to get me where I am right now. So one thing that was in my mind every time, like, I have to give something back to my parents right now. I have to do it for them. I have to do it for my parents, grandparents, and everyone who have contributed for me to be where I am. So they have all their contributions, and I knew I had to give something back to them. So that was my main motivation. And I would say I kept working for them.
Okay, nice. And when you, like, there might have been days when you were not consistent. So we are very hard on ourselves normally that, okay, we missed a day, we didn't practice today. How did you cope up with that?
So when you miss a day, when you know, like, you are not missing regularly. So I think missing a day is not a very big problem if you know that you are consistent. Like, if you are consistent and you miss a day, and then you are like, okay, no problem. It was like a break point. But if you are not, if you know inside, everyone knows on the inside that they are not consistent or they are consistent. So if you are not consistent and you miss one more day, you will feel like...
You'll feel guilty. You'll feel... Yes. Got it. Understood.
So when I used to miss a day, I didn't really bother much because I knew I was consistent.
So basically you missed a day, but then you continued being consistent from the very next. So that cycle didn't stop for you, basically. I got your point. All right. Thank you so much, Rhythm. It was really nice to hear your story. Congratulations again. It's a great news. I think the entire Programming Pathshala team is really proud. And you and your family are as well. All the very best for the next phase and chapter of your life.
Thank you. Thank you so much.